Sri S. Muthukaruppan.
Honorable Deputy Chairman, sir, thank you for the opportunity to speak on the Aadhaar and Other Laws Bill 2019, introduced by the Honorable Minister of Law and Justice and Electronics and Information Technology. The bill amounts the Aadhaar targeted delivery of financial and other subsidies, benefits and services Act 2016, the Indian Telegraph Act 1885 and the Prevention of Money Laundering Act 2002. The Aadhaar Act provides targeted delivery of subsidies and benefits to individuals residing in India by assigning them unique identity numbers called Aadhaar numbers, while over 122 Aadhaar numbers have been generated as claimed by the Union Government. It becomes all the more important to have a regulatory framework due to the widespread use of Aadhaar by citizens of our country. The bill seeks to provide for 12-digit Aadhaar number and its alternate numbers generated by the authority in such manner as may be specified by regulations to conceal the actual Aadhaar number of an individual. This is a welcome step as it tries to restore and protect the privacy of the individual concerned. The bill also seeks to amend the provisions for giving an option to children who are Aadhaar number holders to cancel their Aadhaar number on attaining the age of 18 years. An individual's identity may be verified by Aadhaar authentication. This authentication involves submitting the Aadhaar number and their biometric and demographic information to the Central Identities Data Repository for verification. The bill additionally allows offline verification of an individual identity without authentication through modes specified by the Unique Identification Authority of India, that is UDAI, by regulations. Further, sir, this is welcome step and it protects the individual from misuse of the Aadhaar credentials by others. During offline verification, the agency must, point number one, obtain the consent of the individual. Number two, must inform them of alternatives to sharing information. Point number three, not collect, use or store Aadhaar number or biometric information. I hope and believe strongly that the checks and balances which are proposed will definitely ensure data protection. The bill amends the Telegraph Act of 1885 and the Prevention of Money Laundering Act 2002 to state that telecom companies, banks and financial institutions may verify the identity of their clients by, number one, the authentication or offline verification of Aadhaar, or number two, the passport, or third, any other documents notified by the central government. The person has the choice to use either mode to verify his identity, and no person shall be denied any service for not having an Aadhaar number. It is clearly evident that the Aadhaar can be voluntary and not a mandatory. Moreover, an entity may be allowed to perform authentication through Aadhaar only when the UDAI is satisfied that it is compliant with certain standards of privacy and security permitted by law, and the authentication is sought for a purpose specified by the central government in the interest of the state. The bill aims to create the Unique Identification Authority of India fund, and all fees, grants, charges received by the UDAI shall be credited to this fund. The bill defines the Aadhaar ecosystem to include enrolling agencies, requesting agencies, and offline verification seeking entities. It allows the UDAI to issue directions to them if necessary for the discharge of its functions under the Act. Moreover, any complaint against an entity in the Aadhaar ecosystem for failure to comply with the Act or the UDAI's directions may invite penalties up to 1 crore rupees on such entities, and the Telecom Dispute Settlement and Appellate Tribunal shall be the appellate authority against the decision of such adjudicating officers, my appeal to the Honorable Minister is that the necessary protection for the data security and privacy of the individual should be ensured. Besides making Aadhaar voluntary and not a mandatory one, all other forms of identities may be either linked with one another or shall be allowed to use by the individual on his or her discretion. The citizens are very much benefited by using Aadhaar as an identity. E-filing of income tax returns, opening bank accounts, getting a passport or pension on time, or a digital life certificate for pensioners, or the LPG subsidy, everything is made hassle-free, smooth by way of submission of Aadhaar as an identity. Life has become so easy with the possession of Aadhaar card. I am very much hopeful that the concerns regarding privacy and data protection are adequately addressed by the government. My party, ADMK, is concerned, fully support this bill. Thank you very much.
Dhanyavaad.